If you take one NMOS or PMOS in this fashion, this is a PMOS transistor, okay, PMOS transistor. It will allow a weak zero to flow to the output. Y is at the output side and A is at the input side and B is the control variable. B is the control variable. So you have a PMOS transistor here, you have a PMOS transistor here. Always in pass transistors, you have to give the input at the source terminal. You have to give input at the source terminal. That is the condition in PMOS transistor. And you have to give the control variable on the gate terminal. You have to give control variable on the gate terminal. You have to take output on the drain terminal. This is the condition in pass transistors, whether it is PMOS or NMOS, whether it is PMOS or NMOS. The condition in pass transistor is input should be given at source terminal, control variable should be given at gate terminal, and output should be taken as at the drain terminal. Okay, and PMOS, it will come to on state only when you give zero as the control variable. When you give zero as the control variable, this PMOS will act as on switch. When it is on switch, it is a short circuit path. Whatever you are giving at the input, it will come at the output. Whatever you are giving at the input, it will come at the output. Now coming to the input, whether you are giving 0 or 1, whether you are giving 0 or 1. If you give 0, there will be a slight variation in the output. Exactly 0 will not come at the output. But when you give 1, it will exactly come at the output. Okay. So it will pass a strong 1 and weak 0. When you are giving 0, a small value very close to 0 will be coming at the output. Okay. Two things you have to remember. In PMOS, if you give control variable 0, only then the transistor will act as on switch. A short circuit path will come. Okay, control variable should be 0. That is the first point. Second point, if you give 1, a strong 1 will be passed at the output. If you give 0 as the input, a weak 0 will be passed at the output. These are the characteristics of PMOS transistor. Now coming to NMOS transistor. If you see NMOS transistor, so if you see NMOS transistor, so NMOS will come to on state only when you give control variable as 1. In NMOS, again, two points you have to remember. If you give control variable as 1, only then NMOS will act as an on switch. So now when it is on switch, a short circuit will be created. And when you give 0 as the input, a strong 0 will come at the output. But when you give 1 as the input, a small variation with respect to 1 will come at the output. So a weak 1 will be passed at the output and a strong 0 will be passed at the output. This is the behavior of NMOS transistor. Okay. Out of these four cases, strong 0, weak 0, strong 1, weak 1, you remember one point, all other things you can make the complementary versions. PMOS will pass a weak 0. You remember this point, PMOS will pass a weak 0. Okay. Then NMOS will pass strong 0. If PMOS is passing weak 0, it will pass a strong 1. So NMOS will pass a weak. Okay, weak 1 means not exactly 1 will come at the output. VDD means the high value, okay, which is equivalent to logic 1. And VDD minus VThevenin, VTH threshold. VDD minus V threshold means a small variation with respect to logic 1 will be created. That will come as the output. Okay, this is the behavior of NMOS transistor. This is the behavior of NMOS transistor. But whether it is PMOS or NMOS, the condition is we have to give input at the source terminal. We have to give input at the source terminal. We have to take output at the drain terminal. We have to take output at the drain terminal. And we have to give control variable at the gate terminal. We have to give control variable at the gate terminal. This is the condition about pass transistors. Now if you see the truth table. So when you are giving 0, the first one is truth table of PMOS transistor. Second one is PMOS for truth table for NMOS transistor. Okay. In PMOS, when you are giving 0, it will act as an on switch. But when you give 1, it will be off switch, open circuited. So output will be high impedance state. output will be high impedance state, Z will come. But when you are giving control variable 0, when you are giving control variable 0, 0 will be passed as weak 0. Okay, PMOS will pass weak 0 and logic 1 will be passed as it is, strong 1. Okay, logic 1 will be passed as strong 1. This is the truth table for PMOS pass transistor. Now coming to NMOS pass transistor. Only when you give logic 1 as the control variable, it will be acting as on switch. NMOS will act as on switch only when you are giving logic 1 as the control variable. So VDD should be given. Okay, logic 1 should be given as the control variable B at the gate terminal of NMOS transistor. So when you give 0, a strong 0 will be passed. But when you give logic 1, a weak 1 will be passed, which is VDD minus V threshold. Okay. But when you are giving 0, NMOS transistor will be off switch. So output will be high impedance state. These are the two points each in PMOS and NMOS transistor. You have to remember. Okay. Now we will check this in software. Okay. Now I am going to the LTSpice window. LTSpice I have switched on. And a new window. I am taking a new window. I will go with, let me try NMOS. So I am going with NMOS 4. Let me try. This is NMOS transistor. And I will take voltage sources. This is gate terminal. I will put one voltage. At the source terminal, I will put another voltage. Ground I want for the voltage sources. Ground connection I want for the voltage sources. I will give wiring. So this is gate terminal. I am connecting variable B. The first V1 is variable B, control variable at the gate terminal. And this is input I am connecting at the source terminal. For the NMOS transistor at the source terminal, I am connecting input. I have to take output at the drain terminal. Also, the substrate should be connected to source. Let me try. So if I give some names at the drain terminal, I will be taking the output. I will put this label at the drain terminal. I am taking the output. I am putting the label. Another label I will take at the source terminal. I am giving input. This is the voltage source. At the source terminal, I am giving input. And then at the gate terminal, I am giving control variable. This is that voltage source control variable at the gate terminal. Okay. These are the names. Now what I will do, control variable should be 1. I told you control variable should be 1. Okay. And you have to give some input. What I will do, I will go with advanced pulse and 0 low voltage and 5 high voltage. Delay I will give 0.5 milliseconds. Rise time 1 millisecond. Fall time 1 millisecond. On time 4 milliseconds and time period 8 milliseconds. Something I will give. Okay. Now if I execute this, okay, simulation time I will give 8 milliseconds. If I execute this, a window will come. Okay, waveform window will come. I will go to this window. I will take both vertically. Okay, if I put vertical, left side circuit, right side waveform window. And right click, add plot point. Okay. In the first window, I will click and execute, run button. Okay. I want control variable. It is a logic 1 throughout. Okay. and I will click in the second window, again run, click on the input, click on the input. This red color is required. Okay, this is the input I have set, and click on the third window, go to execute, and the drain point I will get the output waveform. Okay, so if you give logic 1 as the control variable, whatever you are giving as the input, as it is coming at the output. Okay, this is what I checked with NMOS transistor. Red color is output, blue color is input. Output is exactly same as input when I am giving logic 1 as the control variable. If you take PMOS, you have to give logic 0. Only then input will come as it is at the output. Okay. So with this, what I have done is with this I have done the pass transistor behavior, NMOS pass transistor behavior.